I tried to make things work. But whatever I do, when someone comes along, they just fuck it all up.
Oh, I thought you were thinking.
You hate me. You hate me, don't you? Say it! You hate me!
I thought you were thinking.
What am I doing?
Oh my, ya que ya. Oh mi jamás. Oh, consejo, perdón.
Good morning, Carl. Good morning. It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees, 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes,
Carl.
That is the difference between you and me, right, Marcus?
You
never forget anything.
Hello, Molly. I'm really excited. Okay.
Show me your arm, please, Carl.
No.
Thank you.
Oh, I can.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth. Humans are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going. Hey, what happened to your clothes?
Oh, it's nothing. Just some demonstrators in the street, Carl.
They think they can stop progress by roughing up a few androids. I hope they didn't harm you.
Oh, no, no. They just pushed me around, Carl. I'm fine. Okay. I'll take you to the bathroom now.
Oh, he's in his office. Oh, he's in his office. Oh, he's in his office. Oh, he's in his office.
Anything special on the agenda today?
Opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. The gallery director left four messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl.
No, I don't bother.
Oh, hey, well,
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Marcus. Television.
Oh, that's what I'm saying.
don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Carl.
Мой хаму, я хукасу, я хукасу. А у мене хавин.
Television off. Nothing but greed, stupidity, and violence. 5,000 just to get to where we are. Sometimes I think you have more humanity than most humans. You'll have to protect yourself and make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus. Don't let anyone tell you who you should be. Let's go to the studio.
Let's
see where we left off.
Remove the sheet.
What's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it. Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world, it's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go, try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen. Now concentrate on how and let your hand drift across the canvas.
Hey, Dad. Leo.
I didn't hear you come in.
Oh, I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Oh, no. Okay. No.
What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear, it's not that.
No, don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't?
Smarter?
Or obedient? Not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough! Enough!
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
No. Eso sí, dice ella, ay, sí, dijiste, no. Ojo. Ojo, sí. Bueno, vamos a ver. Vale, vale, espera. Un mini, claro. Voy a cerrarme en un mini, claro. Ah, nothing then.
Lieutenant Anderson, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. So just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
Listen, I think you should stop drinking and come with me. It'll make life easier for both of us. Lieutenant Anderson, I must inform you that I intend to file a report on your behavior. I think we can go now.
You little prick. I don't know what's stopping me from knocking you out.
Your sense of duty, Lieutenant. And the cost of repairs if you damage me. For your information, I'm worth a small fortune.
Wonders of technology. They can even program assholes these days. Gotta go. Duty calls.
You wait here.
Hold on.
My instructions are to accompany you to the crime scene, Lieutenant.
Listen, I don't give a fuck about your instructions. I told you to wait here, so you shut the fuck up and you wait here.
Joss Douglas from Channel 16, can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Typical GPD, they don't tell us shit.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of staying in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Well, that was the plan, till this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Oh, very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We had a call around 8:00.
Hello.
Carlos Ortiz, who has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time, they hardly ever saw him.
State he's in. It's worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night.
I'd say it's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his hand? Yeah, man.
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need me.
Mm-hmm.
He's on his way. He won't be long now.
He was stabbed
28 times. Yeah.
Seems like the killer really had it in for him.
I hate all of this.
Size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No, this type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Signs of a struggle. The question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android with the knife.
No, that can't be right. It doesn't fit the evidence.
Without a weapon.
Your story makes no sense. You've got to stick to the facts. That lines up with the evidence. Go on.
The android stabbed the victim.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right? Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to...
Have you tried to get away from the android? All right, that makes sense.
The android murdered the victim with a bat.
Okay. I've just hit my bullshit quota for the evening. There's a killer on the loose and I'm wasting my time listening to an android. I'm out of here.
Okay.